Hey, it's Liz DiAlto, and this is the Untame the Wild Soul Woman podcast. From body image, sex, spirituality, money, and relationships, to motherhood, creativity, business, communication, and desire, Untame the Wild Soul Woman is the place to come for real stories and powerful advice to help you reclaim and redefine womanhood in the 21st century. Elizabeth DiAlto here, your host for the Untame the Wild Soul podcast. And on today's Ask Elizabeth episode, I'm going to address a question that I get really often in various contexts, which is, okay, I know I should trust my body, but how do I actually do that? And instead of giving you any kind of step-by-step how-to, what I want to do is I want to give you some proof. I learned from one of my teachers that confidence comes from evidence. And if we're going to be able to do something effectively, we need to be able to do it confidently. So in today's episodes, I'm going to share a couple of stories with you to give you the proof. And then at the end, I actually have an exercise that you can do for yourself in your own life to excavate for the proof that already exists in your experience. Now, before I dive in, I want to let you know two really cool things that we've got going on. The first is this. Next month in May, we are going to launch something called the Wild Soul Insider. And that is going to be for people who love listening to the podcast and who want to go a little bit deeper with some of our guests or go a little bit deeper with some of these Ask Elizabeth topics. So every month we'll be putting out 3 or 4 bonus episodes. They'll only be 20 minutes with a lot more nitty-gritty how-to and content and actionable items and details from me personally and also hand-selected guests of mine who I really want to teach you certain things, and not just based on my own desires, but based on the questions you ask in the Facebook group, the things that you share, the things that I know are present concerns of yours. So super, super excited for the Wild Soul Insider to begin in May. And if you want to be the first one to know when that's live and you can start signing up, you can go to untameyourself.com/insider-waitlist. The other reason I'm excited for this is because of all the things I do, I know I constantly have people who want to do things, but for whatever reason, just can't make the financial commitment. And so for the Wild Soul Insider, this will be the lowest financial commitment of anything I've ever offered. So I'm super excited for it to be accessible and also have some perks. So I will be releasing full details of the Wild Soul Insider probably sometime next week. But in the meantime, get on the waitlist if you want in on that. untameyourself.com/insider-waitlist. The other thing is this, for those of you who love the book and who have been waiting to get your physical hands on it, the print book is coming. Pre-orders will start sometime next week. We're still working out some of the official details and they will ship out in May all over the world. So no matter where you live, we can ship you a copy of the print book. So if you want to be one of the first 75 people, I'm actually going to be sending out 75 free copies and they'll be signed. You just cover the shipping. So keep your eyes peeled for that next week as well when pre-orders open to be one of the first 75 to order. I might be able to have more than 75 of those available. I haven't heard back from my print team yet. So that's a possibility. Or it might just be 75. Either way, those are the exciting things we've got going on in the untamed world this week. And now let's get into how to trust your body. So I want to tell you two stories. Last year in June of 2015, and it's interesting how I always remember exactly where I was in these moments, exactly how they happened. I was sitting in my hotel room in London in Waterloo, and I was doing my first bit of work with Dove UK for this consulting project I did with them last year. And I had purchased, so that was June, I guess, like 3 months earlier, I had purchased my ticket to go to Burning Man. Those of you who don't know what Burning Man is, it's this festival, kind of really amazing event where people set up, and then people, it's like 70,000 people set up a city in Black Rock City, Nevada, where a city doesn't actually exist. People just roll in, they build it. There's all kinds of art and amazing experiences for a week. So you basically build a city in a week in the desert and go have really incredible experiences. So Michael has been going to Burning Man for a couple years. I've always been curious, but kind of tentative about it. But I bought my ticket and I was going to go. And I remember starting to feel Burning Man happens in August. So once the summer hit, I started to feel really uneasy about my decision to go to Burning Man. And I remember finally one night deciding I'm not going to go. And so I let Michael know I wasn't going to go to Burning Man. I had my tickets. I needed to sell them. They're super easy to sell. People always want to go to Burning Man. I literally posted it on Facebook and 6 minutes later already had someone PayPaling me the money for the ticket. So, but I just knew. I didn't know why, but I just knew I couldn't go to Burning Man last year. Fast forward, my consulting project with Dove UK, the details were specifically outlined, but the time frame wasn't. And it turns out that that very same week I was supposed to be going to Burning Man, I actually had to go back to London to finish out the project. And not only did I go back to London, but I got to spend one of the most amazing days of 2015 with Megan Watterson, who's been a podcast guest, Lisa Lister, who's been a podcast guest, and Dr. Chris Northrup. We all met up in Glastonbury in the UK and had just like a very mystical, beautiful, really, it felt like a pilgrimage. Very, very, very special day. Which I wasn't at Burning Man. I was supposed to be at Burning Man that week. And so I'm sharing this story with you, and I'm going to give you one other one very similar to that, because in my body, I knew I couldn't go to Burning Man. I didn't know why, but I just knew I couldn't. And so I made that choice, and I made that choice even though I was letting Michael down and I was letting other people down who were excited for me to go. I knew for me, I couldn't go. Okay, so fast forward to now this year. We booked a trip, we being me and Michael, to Japan months ago, back in the fall. And it was April 1st to the 18th. And unlike my Burning Man experience, I didn't get the gut feeling that I shouldn't be going to Japan months out. It became really, really, really loud and really, really, really present about 2 weeks before we were supposed to leave for the trip. And at that point, none of my money was refundable, I thought. My flight, you know, the trip cost $2,000. So this was going to be a $3,000 decision to go or not to go. But I sat down. And for those of you who are wanting to get more specific around how to feel into the yeses and the nos and these really deep truths in your body, I have a practice for that. And we'll put the link in the show notes. So this, I believe, is episode number 94. So if you go to untameyourself.com/episode-94, we'll put the link to the yes, no truth practice in the show notes. And so I sat down, I did my practice, and I got such a strong no that I knew I couldn't go to Japan. I knew Michael was going to be upset. He was super excited to go with me. So again, at the risk of really disappointing someone, I chose to just trust my body's wisdom. And I thought, and so what's interesting is when you make these choices, sometimes you think you know why you're making them. I thought I just needed to like rest and relax and be home and ground and not go on this hectic travel adventure. But so the day I'm actually filming this on Tuesday, this episode goes up on Wednesday. And last night, on Monday night, my grandma passed away. And so on Thursday, I'm going to fly home to the East Coast to go be with my family and go to the wake and the funeral. And to do that from San Diego is, I mean, so, so, so easy. It didn't even cost me $200 to change a flight I already had booked. I was planning on going home in a couple weeks, but just so much easier. I would have been in Japan, and I would have had to figure out how to like book a last minute flight and get home from Japan. It would have been so much more hectic and stressful. So my body just knew, don't go to Japan. And you know, it has been great to be home and ground and to relax, but to be able to just stop and drop everything and go home and be with my family right now was really, really important. So I share those two stories with you because we don't always know why, but when you get that yes or that no or something feels so true and so important to you, to be in the practice of listening to it, even though you don't know why, even though you don't understand, is so, so, so important. So in our culture, we do get attached to understanding why, being able to explain things, knowing the reasons for things, or putting meaning on things. And so again, I super, super encourage you when it comes to trusting your body to just go with your gut. When you've sat with something And when you know that you feel a very strong yes, no, or something feels true, or there's that pull, and your body is screaming the answer at you, just trust it. Just be in the practice of trusting it. And so the exercise I want to give you to gather the proof that already exists in your own life is to just sit down with your journal. And I want you to just think on times in your life when it goes both ways. You either had a really deep intuitive knowing about something and you followed it and it worked out in your favor, or you had a really deep intuitive knowing about something and you didn't listen to it and it really bit you in the ass later on. And so gather this list and have this evidence-based list, and maybe you even have a special journal just for these things. I love these little pop-in notebooks. They're like little journals. If you're watching, you can see I'm holding up, I don't know, it's probably just like 1, 2, 3, maybe it's like a 4x4 or a 4x3 little kind of pocket-sized journal. I love those for dedicating to specific things. Maybe you just keep a running list of all these times your intuition was successful and it led you in the right direction, so you can start to see how they add up and build your confidence and build your faith, because it's based on evidence that it's okay to do that. That'll help you decondition whatever you've been programmed to not trust your body or to not trust your intuition, and just give you solid proof that it's okay to do that. And so keep that list by you and check it often, and then continue to add new things to it as you get more into the habit and more into the practice of this. So thank you so, so much for listening. Thank you for being here today. As always, if you want to continue the conversation, come on over to the private Facebook group. It's a free Facebook group. Go to untameyourself.com/Facebook, and I'll either see you in there or just in our next episode. Thanks.
When I'm meditating during the day, it is how I solve problems. If I am up against a huge problem or I need to make a major decision, I meditate on it because I can solve problems that I could sit with for 3-4 hours on my computer, laying out all these different scenarios, thinking about the decision from so many different angles. But I can solve all of that in a 10 or 15 minute meditation if I just quiet my mind and hear my own inner voice and hear what comes through my intuition.